Torej, razstava Magnum prvič, ki jo predstavljamo v galeriji Jakopič, nosi originalni naslov Obraz časa, pod katerim je bila v letih 1955 in 56 predstavljena v petih avstrijskih mestih.
It was me who got a phone call in 2006 by the French Institute in Innsbruck, announcing to me that they found an old exhibition in their basement. The original title of this exhibition was Gesicht der Zeit, Face of Time, and it featured 8 Magnum photographers with around 80 photographs, all mounted on painted plywood.
No in takrat dalje seveda velja za prvo odkrito skupinsko razstavo Magnumovih fotografov nasploh.
The exhibition is a little bit like archaeological, how can you say, trouvaille, like a mummy that has been buried for half a century and suddenly came back to light. Therefore, it's also a little bit frozen in time. However, we changed the title of the exhibition to Magnum's First, because till today, this is the oldest known photo exhibition by Magnum Photos. And we had to restore the images that we found, because they were in very, very, very bad condition, very dirty, covered with dust and fungus and other horrible things. This is the first presentation in Slovenia. The exhibition has started in 2007 in Vienna, because we thought if we present it in Austria first, we would be able to gather some information on the exhibition, because we lack any, how can I say, testimonial on the exhibition by a living person. All we could find out was from the little press clippings that we could find from the 1950s in Austria, and what we kind of could deduct from what we found in the crates together with the photographs. These photographs have been assembled by a curator. We don't know who that person was. It has been shown in 1955, June, July, for the first time in Innsbruck at the French Institute. And then it has traveled, and this we know from stickers that we found in the original crates, to Vienna, Bregenz and Linz, before actually going back to Innsbruck, being put in the basement by some person and being forgotten for the next 50 years.
Tudi v samih fotografijah avtorjev, ki so tukaj predstavljeni, vendarle se enigme prav tako skrivajo, predvsem pri Robertu Capi, kjer ugotavljamo, da po vsej verjetnosti manjkajo prve 4 fotografije. Prav tako Robert Capa ni vključen v uvodni del razstave. Robert Capa se na drugi strani seveda tukaj predstavlja z zase netipičnimi fotografijami. Fotograf, ki ga poznamo kot fotoreporterja smrti, kot so ga poimenovali kot enega najboljših vojnih reporterjev nasploh, je tukaj predstavljen z, lahko rečem, kar pacifističnimi prizori iz baskovske pokrajine. Nedolžen vaški praznik v Baskiji predstavljajo, tudi pritrjene so bile na zeleno pobarvane vezane plošče. No, poleg Roberta Cape je eden od ustanoviteljev agencije Magnum tudi Henri Cartier-Bresson, ki se predstavlja z drugo, lahko rečem, zelo pomembno fotoreportažo, ki je bila tudi v času svojega izida v reviji Life leta 1948 izjemno pomembna. In sicer gre za zadnje dneve življenja Mahatme Gandija in pa njegov atentat in dneve potem, ko so ga upepelili in tudi pokopali. Gre za reportažo, ki znova dokazuje, da je bil Henri Cartier-Bresson fotoreporter, ki se je znal o pravem trenutku znajti na pravem mestu. Imel je nos za politične dogodke in je tako seveda posnel dejansko povsem zadnje fotografije indijskega voditelja.
So, my name is Marco Bischof. I'm the son of Swiss Magnum photographer Werner Bischof, who died in 1954. I was a very small boy at the time, 4 years old, and unfortunately I never met him in person, but now, since 25 years, I'm caring about his archive. So I'm telling you a couple of things about the flute player. The flute player that used to be one of the iconic pictures in the 50s, and now in the meantime became, you know, like human heritage. It's a 15-year-old boy about in the Peruvian Andes, and many people compare it to the lightness of being. And I think it's a very interesting picture because, you know, like it's like we all walk through life. And this young man, he walks through life. He has his flute, his fun part of life. He has also his burden, but he is free. And specifically, you know, like nowadays where people have so many things and they kind of try to get rid of them and they're not happy and all these things, this picture still symbolizes that lightness of being. And this interesting wave, like music waves in the background, is an old field method of doing fields from the native people there, from the Incas, and they did the fields like mother breasts, you know, like here's one and then there's another one here, and this is to make the god, or you know, like the god of Pachamama, the mother earth, to make her grow a lot of things. So I think it's perfectly the composition of these waves, and on the other side the music and the man who is on the way, and it's a very symbolic picture, and I think that's one of the reasons why this picture still is these days where you can't find too many people looking like that in Peru anymore, unfortunately, but it's still one of the icons that symbolizes all these things.
Nam nekoliko bolj domače prizore pa prinašajo fotografije kar treh avtorjev, in sicer Marca Ribuja, ki se predstavlja s fotoreportažo iz Dalmacije, ki jo je zaključil z intrigantno fotografijo Titovega portreta, ki ga prenašajo nazaj na njegovo mesto, kjer je bil izobešen. Jean Marquis se predstavlja prav tako s prizori nam bližnje okolice, in sicer iz Madžarske, Budimpešte in okolice, medtem ko je Lessing zabeležil sproščene prizore dunajskih otrok, predmestno hišo, dunajski dečki pri petju, otroci, ki se igrajo v pratru in tako naprej, skratka sproščeni prizori. nekoliko bolj komercijalen projekt, ki pa se ga je lotil Ernst Haas, je bilo snemanje oziroma fotografiranje snemanja legendarnega hollywoodskega spektakla Howarda Hawksa v letu 1955 Dežela faraonov. Gre za fotografiranje snemanja, ki ga je uprizarjalo 4000 igralcev in sam avtor je seveda povedal, da je bilo snemanje izjemno naporno, bil je čas Ramadana, tudi puščavski pesek in vročina pa seveda statistom in igralcem nista prizanašala. Med samimi moškimi predstavniki je tukaj še Inge Morath. Inge Morath je bila prva fotoreporterka, ki se je pridružila agenciji Magnum. Rojena je bila v Gracu in ostala tudi Slovenijo, precej povezana vse življenje, kajti njena mati je bila slovenskega porekla in je tudi kasneje dosti sodelovala, denimo tudi slovenskimi umetniki in tudi ustvarjala v bližini slovenskih meja. Gre pa za serijo, ki jo je posnela v najbolj konzervativnih delih Londona, Soho in Mayfair. Inge Morath je sama povedala o tej seriji, da je zelo slabo govorila angleško, takrat, ko se je šla neke vrste paparacovskega fotografa med gospodo, ki je seveda se sprehajala po londonskih ulicah. Verjetno je bila prav Inge Morath, in to je seveda še ena uganka, ki spremlja to razstavo, tista, ki je organizirala to skupinsko razstavo Magnumovih fotografov v Avstriji. A ne glede na ta nerazrešena vprašanja, ne smemo pozabiti, da ta razstava predstavlja tudi za fotografijo izredno pomemben moment, kajti ravno v tem času se začenja prisotnost fotografije ne več le na straneh časopisov, temveč tudi na stenah umetnostnih galerij.